Moving at the speed of feet can't keep on the
moving like the speed of sound. Feet can't keep on the ground.
What's good, YouTube? Easy Now 1337, aka Snow, back again with another emblem. And today we have the cereal guy meme face thing. And it was pretty beast, and it's not too difficult to make, so let's just get straight into it. Firstly, go to layer 1, open a round square, make it bigger, and that's sorted. Next, go to layer 2, grab a half circle, make it black, make it smaller. And you're just going to want to skew this down and to the right and up and to the right as well, just to make it like longer and also bigger as well, if that makes sense. Now you want this to cover the bottom three lines of the grid, and you want it to just hit the first grid line on the left. So you see I'm touching the edge now with the half circle, just move it over to the first line of the grid, and you want it to just go over the third layer up from the bottom, and that is fine. Duplicate that layer by pressing select or back on layer 2, going up, changing it to white and just moving it down and to the right a little bit. This just gives the outline of the table. Just skew it, mess around with it up and left a little bit, and that is the table done. Next, you want to grab a normal square, which is down here, make that black, make that smaller, and you want to pull this down below layer 2. And this is going to be the back of the chair, and you want this chair to be pretty much all the way to the left of the half circle, and just make it a bit bigger, a bit wider, like so. About there will do fine. Up to you though where you guys want to put it. Duplicate that layer, pull that layer down below the half circle as well, and make that white and make it smaller. Skew it up and to the left so that it keeps the shape of the outside black line. Now duplicate layer 2 again, move it down below the half circles as well, make it smaller and skew it up and to the left, and just put it back there. That gives the like the 3D-ish look of the chair, and we can always sort that out later anyway if you want to fix it up a little bit. Next, go to layer 5, duplicate that, make it smaller. Actually, let's not duplicate it, let's go into and select another half circle, make it black, rotate it and make it smaller, and we're going to place it about here. Just fiddle around with it till you get something you like, make sure it's a straight line across the top of the half circle. Duplicate that layer, make it white and make it smaller, and move it up a little bit so there's a nice thick black outline. Jump in and grab a normal circle, make it black, make it smaller, and skew it up and to the left, and then rotate it around and just make it a bit bigger. And you want this black circle to join each side in the top corners. Duplicate that, make it white and make it smaller, and that is the bowl done. Perfect. Next, go in and grab this thing, the half tube, make it black, make it smaller. And this is going to be the spoon that goes in. Not necessary to be perfect, but it's just a nice little touch. So I'm just going to leave it there and have it going over there like so. Perfect. Next, go in and grab a half circle. Not a half circle. Curved line. Make it black. Make it smaller. And we're going to place this about here, like so. Let me just move it down below the table area. Now you can skew this down and to the right and just have it nicely fitted there like so. And next, go in and grab a black circle, make it black. Yeah, well, obviously make it black because I just said black circle. Yay. Now you want this to go pretty much near the top of the emblem, but you definitely want it to go just below half the grid line. As you can see, that the circle is now around the center of the emblem, so you want it to just be joining onto the body and go just below the middle layer, if that makes sense, the middle grid line. And then duplicate that layer, make it white and make it smaller. Make it relatively thick, the black line, but not over the top thick. I'm actually just going to make it a bit bigger. So, and I'm just going to move the body over to the right a little bit, like so. Next, go in and grab, well, you don't need to grab anything, duplicate layer 13, make it smaller, and this is going to be his eyes. So you want one eye about there, move it up just a little bit, duplicate that layer and move it across, and he's got the other eye on the other side. Grab a half tube, make it black, make it smaller, and scoot by going up and to the left just to make it thinner and longer, and then duplicate that layer and set the other one up above, like his eyebrows raised. And I'm just going to move that eye over a little bit. Perfect. We'll get back to the rest of the face in a second. What I want you to do is grab a curved line, make it black, make it smaller. And I want you to skew this down and to the right, and also up and to the right a little bit just to make it a bit thicker. This is going to be the start of his arm. Duplicate that layer, flip it around, and skew this one up and to the left. Now this arm, you need to make it the same thickness as the one that you just made just before, and you want it to just cross over the left hand side of the actual chair. And then duplicate that layer, flip it around, and just make it a bit smaller and have it just about there. So it just looks like the rest of his arms connecting to the actual spoon. And now to do the finish off the arm, grab a half circle, make it black, make it smaller, and just connect the two sides. Skew it up and to the left just to give it a nice perfect shape around. Duplicate that layer, make it white, and make it smaller, and scoot up and to the left as well. Make sure the arm's thickness stays pretty much the same all the way around. I mean, it's not too noticeable if it's slightly thinner, but if you want a perfect emblem, just mess around with it until you get it perfect. And grab another half circle, make it black, make it smaller, rotate it, and just add this onto the end of the arm so it's not a straight line arm. You got a nice little rounded hand, like so. Next, go in and grab a circle, make it black, make it smaller, and this is going to be his mouth. So skew it up and to the left and then give it a rotate, and just mess around with it until you get it to about this size, about this shape, like so. Jump in and grab a half circle, leave it white, make it smaller, skew it down and to the right a little bit and just place it about there, like so. And let me just do the rings, grab the rings, make them black and make them smaller. Duplicate them, put them at the top three layers for now. I'm just gonna leave them there for a second and I'll sort them out in a moment. So now we've got three layers left. What you should do is grab a circle, white, make it smaller and place it about here, skew it up and to the left and rotate it, and just add it to the side of his mouth. This is going to be like his tongue, or what his tongue should be. And I'm just going to change this just a little bit. I'm going to rotate it to the left a little bit more, make it a bit bigger, and I'm going to skew that down and to the right and up and to the left until I just get a nice, I mean up and to the right and down and to the right just to get it a nice shape, a nice size, and place it about there. And move the tongue down. It's just about fiddling and getting it to how you like, as I always say with my emblems. And I'm just going to make those a bit smaller for a second. And then with these last two layers, we're just going to do the cheek. Now with the cheek, I can't even remember what I used, to be honest. Let me just have a look through quickly. Oh yeah, it would have been this. The tongue, make it black, make it smaller. And we're going to skew this down and to the right. Flip it by pressing select or back on it. And place it about there, duplicate it, make it white, and make it smaller. Like so. Perfect, and then you can move the rings over a little bit, make them a bit smaller. And the mouth just isn't sitting right with me, so I'm just going to skew it up and to the left and move it up a bit. Just so it's in line with the actual cheek. The side of the mouth that's curved is in the curve of the cheek, bang in line with it. And then just move that up a little bit. Move the tongue into place, and there we go, serial guy meme. Mess around with it, open up a picture of it, look at it, get it to how you like. It doesn't have to be the exact same as mine, but I think I've got the best serial guy on YouTube at the moment. So I hope you enjoyed that, guys. More emblems coming soon, more gameplays, all that sort of good stuff. So yeah, peace out, guys, take care. Sometimes I wonder if I'll ever make it, but there's only one way I'ma know.